Good morning, hello, welcome to Natasha Makes. I was just trying to find me on here so I can see all your messages. Ah, it'll come up in a minute, I'm sure. I just had a little message from technical support saying, Natasha, turn the clock, you're live. Morning. Lovely to have you company. Let's just have a little double check that we are live everywhere. Can we just check that? See, this is the joy of it all, isn't it? New technology. Trying to find out. Live on the website. Good. That's a good start. That is, for anybody watching that wants to go on the website, www.natashamakes.com. Did you know you can watch there as well? I get everywhere in a safe and responsible way. Obviously. Where are we? Can anybody find me on Facebook? Are we live? Are we there? Anywhere? See, we had to change all sorts of different things. I can't find it. Are we live on Facebook? Can someone tell me? No, I'm not seeing it on Facebook either. Oh, we're not on Facebook. No, definitely not on Facebook. I'm sure tech will sort that out. Not sure why it's not there. Apologies. Hang on. Let's sort this out. Don't know why it's not done that. But hello to everybody else that is watching one way or another. Well, we'll sort that out. We'll get to Facebook. How are you? Very rude of me to be there and not with you here. Just trying to find out. I'm sure I will get a message when we do manage to sort out why I'm not on Facebook. We have got lots for you this week. Those of you that have been looking on Facebook will have already seen that we've got lots of gorgeous fabrics. There is a little something that we're going to start doing now on Thursdays, because do you know what? Thursdays can be a bit meh, can't they? You know, you're not quite at the weekend. I might be on the wrong one. Might be on the wrong one. We'll get there. You might be able to find me right now on the Natasha. We're all good on YouTube. Oh, we just need to wait for Facebook to catch up. Anyway, yes, so Thursdays, like I was saying, Thursdays we're going to start doing something on a regular basis. So we're going to launch it today. I know it's not Thursday, but I just thought I would launch it because we've got a show, so I can tell you all about it. So on Thursdays, we're going to have a thing called Half Meter Heaven. And what will happen is I will load up loads of braces of half meter. So a brace is two, right? So you'll have two, so you'll have a pattern fabric and a plain to go with it. So use your plain for your lining or something like that, or a contrast. But you'll have a really designer, gorgeous fabric, and then a contrast, or you know, a complementary plain fabric, and a half meter of each, and that will be $9.99. And we're going to do that every Thursday for you, so that you can. That's where you can find that. So that's what we're going to start doing. So we thought we would launch it today. And those of you that have been on Facebook and are Facebook savvy will know that that has already launched. That launched last night. So moving all my demo stuff out of the way. I've been prepping, don't you know? Yes. But I need to be able to show you. And unpicking, yeah, as well. This morning sort of crept up on me. Don't know about you, but it really did creep up on me. Woke up at 22 minutes past three. I thought, I've got loads of time. Then before I knew it, poof, we're here. I don't know if we can swap that over. Are we all good? Not on Facebook. No. Don't know if we're... Oh, there we go. Oh, I'm on the wrong one. They've put me on the wrong page. That's why. Oh, so some of you have found me. What can we do about that then? Anything? Nothing? Hang on. Bear with. Don't know. What can we do? Right. Let me just see. Shall I just carry on? Hang on. Let me just ask everybody that. Shall I just carry on? Yeah. Technical. You'd have thought, wouldn't you? What happened was, in the week, we had to change. Obviously, each of these cameras streams into, it's all very technical, streams into something, and then you have to have all the codes that go to Facebook and YouTube and the website and everything else. And we had to change all those codes because I had to do all of my demo videos for Hochanda, because they're trying to limit the number of people there, obviously. So I'm only allowed in one day a week. Hello. Hi, Josh. Hello, hang on, I'm going to put you on speaker.
Hi,
you are live. Hi, everyone can hear.
Hello.
Yeah. Hi, everyone.
So we've got two options.
Two options. What would you like to do?
Stay on the page that we're on now.
Stay on the page we're on. Wrong page.
Cancel this stream now.
Cancel.
Ask people to move over to Natasha Makes Facebook and all.
How many people have we got on the other stream?
On Natasha McCarthy Facebook page, yeah. It's currently 62.
Yeah, let's swap and go over to the proper one. Start
okay.
It on there.
Yeah,
it's where it's meant to be.
We'll
do.
We'll
do.
All
right. Thank you. Bye bye. Okay, so you might have just gathered, technical support, that we are going to start. It's on, basically, they put up all the links onto the wrong Facebook page. So we're going to stop that Facebook Live. We're going to switch it to Natasha Makes, which is where it should be. Join us there in a couple of minutes. We'll just have a little chat about stuff. So, apologies for that. That's what happens, you see. When we had to cut all the links and everything, we had to then put all the links back in, went onto the wrong Facebook page. It happens. So, what we're going to do for you this morning, I'm going to run through all the different fabrics that we've got on the website. So, we've got a new page on our website. Website details down. Yay, I've got the right side. Hooray. Down there. NatashaMakes.com, www.natashamakes.com. You can watch us live there and you can find all sorts of goodies there. So to start us off, now normally, you will have, it'll be a half metre of plain and a half metre of designer fabric. But you know what I'm like, when I manage to get fabric at cracking prices, I pass that discount on. So I managed to get hold of some lovely, lovely, lovely Heather Bailey. So this is strangely called Sprout. Sprout in ginger. Not sprouting as in like sprout, it's called Sprout in ginger. And actually, when you buy sprouts at Christmas time, if you buy them actually on the thing, they do come in a thing like that, don't they? And then from the same range, so it's exactly the same soft pink, we have gold. There we go, we've got that to go with it. And I thought that they were rather lovely. I'm going to fling these over the sewing machine so that you can see them. And these are for both half metres, there you go, for both half metres, £9.99. And what can you do with a half metre of each of those fabrics? Bag make! You can make lots of bags. So look, that's one that my lovely friend Gemma made. And that's just out of half a metre of each of those fabrics. Lovely, isn't it? She was very proud of herself. She's like, I've done a boxed bottom and everything. She has. She made a cracking job of it. So I'm enjoying that hugely. And look, she did one handle in one of the fabrics and one handle in the other. I rather love that. So that is an example of what you can do with your half metre of fabric. That's not the bag we're making today. The bag that we're making today is actually a reversible bag. Actually, I think that bag's reversible as well, but this is this one. This is what we're going to make today. It will feature, well, it can feature whatever fabrics you wish. But certainly the planes that are matched with those fabrics are perfect for this, absolutely perfect for this. So there we go. And the nice thing is that this is also reversible. I'll show you that in just a minute. We'll get to that. I've been making these bags for years. Right, so that is your Heather Bailey, and this is on the new deals page on the website. So go and check that out. When it's gone, it's gone. I won't be getting any more of it. It's from the Clementine range. And yeah, like I say, when it's gone, it's gone. So do make the most of that. There we go. And you too could be making gorgeous bags like that. Okay, so that's the first one. Tomorrow's shows, lots of you getting very excited. We're going to be making storage. Yes, we are. I've got special stabilizers in and everything for you. I'm going to put that bag there for a second. Yeah, special stabilizers in and everything. But what handy, handy sizes they are. And I love the little one. So cute. So that's, and they stack as well. So we're going to be making those. That's tomorrow's show. Lots of you have been asking about that. Let's have a look then at, I'm sure I will get. Oh, there we go. Oh, hang on, bear with me. I've got to just take a quick photo of something. Ah, oh my goodness me. There we go. So all the passwords can be changed. It's all very technical. All very technical. Right, okay, hopefully that should do it. And then hopefully we can swap over onto the correct Facebook page. And hopefully everyone will be able to find us there. Right, in the meantime, let's start having a look at these gorgeous fabrics, shall we? Now, I haven't got stock updates on these. These were loaded last night. The only one I know that's definitely sold out, definitely, I think, was that one with the pink. Isn't that gorgeous? I don't know if I can get that again, but if I can, I will for you. So I'm just going to put that aside, because that is someone's. Pop that there. So well done if that was you and you managed to get hold of that. Now, let's have a look. This is your cactus dahlias, which are rather gorgeous. And again, it's half a metre, so that will be. And these are all 100% cotton, 44 inches selvage to selvage and quilting weight. There we go. So this is Philip Jacobs 4K Fassett. And the colour work, the print, everything just works so beautifully, isn't it, with that. And then I wanted to pick out those blues in there, because there are some beautiful blues. So I've mixed it in with an aqua. And I just thought that that was rather gorgeous. Do you want a close-up? There we go. Da-da-da-da. Beautiful fabric. There we go. And there it is with that lovely aqua blue. So, again, all on the website. If you can't find it, it's look on the deals page. So you can search on the left-hand side when you go onto the website. You can watch live and all that thing. And then it says shop. And underneath all of them is a new page called deals. Because, you know, whilst we're in these strange times, we thought it would be really nice to bring the best value that we possibly can for you. I have got 7 of these. Now, it might be that you bought this with the paisley last week, but we didn't have enough paisley to make any more kits. So what we've done instead, look at this, this is your brassica. Again, this is another Philip Jacobs for the Kaffe Fassett Collective. So it's sort of, it's just part of that bundle. And there it is. There we go, that lovely pale colour, sort of pale minty colour. And again, $9.99. All of these are $9.99 for you this morning, making it affordable. There we go. These have all been cut, by the way. So if you if you're looking, if you're buying multiples, because I know some of you have been buying multiples this morning, then they are already cut. So if you're buying multiples, they'll come as the half meters already cut. Now, what about this one? So the thinking behind the half meter heaven on a Thursday, which we're launching on a Monday, as we're not live on a Thursday, is, there we go, look at that, gorgeous. This is called Shaggy, by the way, is to allow you guys to boost your stash. And when I've got a bit of fabric left on a bolt that isn't enough to put into a kit, I will sell it to you at this reduced rate, so that you guys can get the fabrics with quantity. You know, that's just it, isn't it? There we are, look at that. So we've got that with, and picked out that blue. So that's what you're getting there. There we are. Oh, I've got a message. Oh, I'm live on Facebook. Hello, hello, hello. Apologies. Do you know what? One day we'll actually get this right. It's so difficult. Not, you don't realise how many technical people do technical things when links break and go wrong and what have you. So hello, welcome. Welcome to Natasha Makes. You're all right. I've just been going through the fabrics that we've got on the website. So www.natashamakes.com. And I was just explaining, we're launching Half Meter Heaven, which is going to start on Thursdays. And what will happen is I will go through my fabric stash and pair a gorgeous designer fabric with a plain. So use that plain for lining or something like that to provide a contrast. And I will put them up half meter of each. You get a full meter of fabric for $9.99 so that you get the chance to boost your stash. If I've got ends of bolts and stuff that actually isn't enough to put into a kit, then it will go into this. But it also gives me a chance, and this is the other thing, to research the kind of fabrics that you like. So I will also get new fabrics in from new designers that I haven't stocked before to see if you like them. And if it sells, then I know that you like it. And that's great. And then I can get in more of that. So it's also sort of market research as well as to which fabrics and which designers you like. So it does many, many things whilst providing you guys with beautiful fabrics. Now, this is the Jungle Paisley. This is, again, another Kaffe Fassett one. And this time with this fabulous deep green. I was on the phone to Emma this morning, and Emma, who does all my accounts and, well, amongst other things, and she was like, oh, I love that jungle green. Yes, yes, yes. There we go. Isn't that fab? Pinks and greens just works a treat, doesn't it? Absolute treat. And it also gives us a chance to, like I say, experiment with new designers, see what you like, see what colours you like. Because otherwise, I'm very aware that I have my tastes as to what I like. And it's very tempting to just buy the stuff that I like. But everybody has slightly different tastes, so I want to cater for everybody. Yeah, that's where we're at. The brassica. Did I call that one the brassica? This is the brassica. What did I call that one? Succulent. That was what that one was. So this is your brassica. And look, we've picked that up with a lovely light green. Ooh, but I can't remember how many of these. I think I only had like 8 or 9 of those. So it is first come, first serve. Like I say, these will be the last bit of a bolt or something like that. So yeah. Make the most of it. Now, this is, like I said, this also gives us a chance to see which designers you like. So this is Riley Blake. And so we've got a few of these because this was an experiment to see if you guys like Riley Blake or if you just love llamas. I love llamas. If you just love llamas, then this might be the one for you. Now, this is the only one that's slightly different because I didn't have quite the right colour. So you've got a little bit of a fabric upgrade with your with what it's teamed with, because what I thought it looked a bit special with is a batik. And I thought that this little chap here went particularly well with that gorgeous batik. So I sacrificed the batik, which has never been to wear before. Actually, neither of these have ever been to wear before at all. So I sacrificed the batik to go, because he went so beautifully with this little chap here and the toes of that one. So that's, you know, in the interests of finding out what you guys like. There we go. So if you love a batik, or if you love a llama, or if you love Riley Blake fabric, then give it a go. I thought it was fun when I saw it, and I was like, yeah, I'll have a bit of that, and see what's going on there. So that's where the llamas came from. Do not be alarmed. Yeah, we went there. Sorry, everybody. So that is that one. Oh, yeah, so the last of the Tilda Rose. beautiful, isn't it? Absolutely beautiful. And this is going with cream. Isn't that... Oh, helps if I actually change the camera, doesn't it? Look at that. So it's all sorts of done. So we've had Kaffe, we've had Moda, we've had Heather Bailey, we've had Riley Blake, we've got some Tilda in there. And that is going with a cream there, just to give it that softness. So that was, yeah, that was just what we had left from some other projects that we had. So that went into the mix. And then, yeah, I had some of the William Morris. Actually, this wasn't a fact that I had some left over. It was just that I know you guys love a bit of William Morris. So half a metre of your William Morris and half a metre of your chocolate brown there. Making William Morris affordable. That's what we want, isn't it? You know, really lovely. So if you've got these fabrics, then you'll be able to make some of these storage boxes. All sorts of things you can do with a half metre. Now, here we go. Here's some Moda. This is from the Summer Breeze collection. I've got 10 of these. Well, I did have. I don't know if I still have. Because I know some of you were going, ooh, and ah, over it this morning. So let me show you this close up. So this is your Summer Breeze. Now, I've paired it with a white because I don't know if you can see how clearly that's coming through, but there is a real bright white that's been used as a highlight. It almost looks like night vision, doesn't it? Or negatives on photos. But I thought that was rather lovely. So I wanted to pull out that strong white there. So half a metre there, half a metre there. There we go. Oh, more trouble with Facebook. What is going on? Ba-ba-ba-ba. Let's have a look. Bear with me. Let's just see if anybody's actually managing to watch on Facebook this morning. Has it all gone wrong? These things happen. Oh, there we go. We're there. Oh, no. Oh, there, no, you see, there's Anne saying she needs a Natasha Mick fix before a funeral. So, oh, no. Oh, Anne, I'm so sorry. Oh, the Paisley Green Jungle's gone. I'm getting live stock updates. Thanks, Ems. So, this is how weird and wonderful our world is these days. So Emma is in Switzerland. That's where she lives at the moment. She's my best friend. She does my accounts, does all of that. And she is giving me stock updates from Switzerland to here because none of the tech team can be here today. Anna's joined us. Anna's joined us for the first time in ages. Anna Sewing That. Anna, Strawberry Thief. That was put on because I know you love it. Anything else that I need to know that has sold out this morning? Are we still doing a discount for key workers? Nikki, yes, we are. If you message info@natashamakes.com, then SJ will give you the code for that. Yeah, Sheila says that she can see her Kaffe collection growing this morning. I'm not going to apologise. I've done this for you to cheer you up so you can get gorgeous fabrics and cheer yourselves up. what better than Natasha Makes and having post from Natasha Makes at the same time? Sue! Oh, yes! And washing in the bath, says June. It's the way to do it. Absolutely the way to do it. In fact, oh no! My husband's just ended the Facebook stream. What's going on? Oh man, it's gone again. Guys, I'm so sorry. What are we going to do? What are we going to do? Hey? Hang on. What is going on? I really apologise for this. I don't know. At some point we will find out what on earth is going on this morning. Well. Who knows? Oh, the tech is... Oh, Facebook has camera issues. Great. We're getting it back up again. getting it back up again. I do apologise, everybody. It's very annoying, isn't it? Very annoying. Right. Okay. Oh. There we go. Pop those in there. Moda. Moda. And this is a designer that I've never featured before, but I thought it was rather lovely. And this is Fanny and Jane. But look at the detail in here. Look at all the detailing in here, isn't it gorgeous? So you've got cranes, you've got turtles, you've got fish in there, you've got all sorts. There's even a rabbit in a jumper. I mean, come on, you've got to love a fabric that has a rabbit in a jumper, right? All sorts, dragonflies. I absolutely adore this fabric. So that is in with that lovely green. Yep, you guessed it. $9.99. It's all there. But I think I only have, I think I've only got about 6 of those. Yeah, that's all I could get my hands on. But worth getting your hands on it if you can. Are we live on Facebook again yet? Has that happened? Oh dear. Dear, oh dearie me. What's going on? Sunset and Cream has gone, apparently. Oh gosh. So that was that one. So that was Studio, that was Elizabeth's Studio. So well done if you got that with the cream. Beautiful, isn't it? So congratulations on that one. That's gone now. Oh, hang on. Let's do a quick stock take. That one's gone. The brassica and lime has gone. Congratulations. The shaggy and the blue has gone. Sounds like a band, doesn't it? Shaggy and the blue. The paisley jungle and the green. I've moved that one already. And Elizabeth Studio got that one. Brassica and mint. One left. Oh, and the cave cactus. That one's gone. There we go. So one left of those. I think we're okay for the Heather Bailey at the moment. And I think we're okay for Llamas and Tilda and William Morris and the Moda. What about the flamingos? I haven't even shown you the flamingos yet. This was a bit of fun. Like the llamas, I thought maybe we could do with a little bit of light-hearted fun. They're quite cute, right? Everyone loves a flamingo. They'd look really nice as storage, actually. And I think I had that in my head when I was putting all these together, that would work. That would definitely work. There we go. So that's your pink and your flamingos. Let's get rid of all of these. And then we can start looking at what we're going to make today. Now, whilst my head was contrasting fabrics, what can we do? I thought, I've been asked lots to do this bag. And every time, I've been making this bag for years. And I still have, in fact, I posted out to my friend because the very first one I made in denim with a red rose contrast top. And actually I posted that up to my friend Emma Claire in Scotland just this last week because it's always been my yarn bag. And she's going to finish off because I'm really rubbish at crochet. I've tried really hard. I can't do it. So she is going to finish off some crochet that I started and post it back. But she gets to keep the bag, and that's a bag that I've been making this for years, and that bag I made before I even had Freddie. So we're talking 7 years I've been making these bags, and they last, and it does look like a t-shirt, which is why it's my t-shirt tote bag. And whenever this is what I take to the market, because I can get, it's actually really roomy and I can get everything in there. So when markets were a thing, And I used to go every Friday or Saturday to the market for all my fruit and veg. I would just hand over a handful of these to Nat at the market and go, there you go, fill, and she'd fill my bags. So that was always lovely. So this is it. But you can either do a plain lining, but what I would like you to bear in mind is that it is in fact fully reversible. And that's why I love it, because I'm a mucky pup and generally I'll grub something on the outside, but if I still want to look presentable, then I can just spin it all around. And there it is. So you can do it like that, or you can just do plain fabrics. In fact, I got a whole load out of the cupboard to show you. A whole load is still at the post office, actually, because I can fit a lot of post in these as well. And they keep handing them back. And the lovely lady at the post office, who's my friend now, even after all of the, they lost two bags of my post tobacco, we're friends. She keeps saying to me, oh, might just keep that one. Like, mm. So, yeah. And also these have been, for me, a great way to use fabrics that maybe wouldn't necessarily go with any of the colours in my house, but I just love the fabrics. It's a great excuse to be able to use those fabrics. So you can just use a plain lining if you want, or you can do it reversible. It's entirely up to you, but I'm really in love with this fabric at the moment, really in love with it. In fact, I didn't even show you that we've got this. That's because I used it. right. So the sample that I would have been showing you, we've got this in the $9.99 bit. Yeah. But have a good rifle through your stash. See what you've got. I've put the pattern up because I'm just aware that a lot of you have probably just bought a lot of fabric. So I've put the pattern up separately. You will need with it pattern paper. Now, I know not everybody has pattern paper and you don't need a pack of three or whatever pages. So I've just ordered and they'll arrive in the next few days. So if you are ordering the pattern today, then what I'll do is I will put a piece of pattern paper in this size, and that's all you need, and you will have some left over. So I will put that in with your instructions. Okay, so you don't have to think, you need it, and if you don't have it, don't worry, it's coming with the instructions. So I will give you instructions as to how to map out, because you need a body part and a top part. And I've got it on two pieces just because I'd already started using up a scrap and then realised I had another full piece here. So that's the main body part there. All of the measurements and everything come in the instructions. So that's your main body part. And then when you get your piece of paper, your top bit will go on the side there. It doesn't fit on top there. It's too tall. And I thought about, could I print it onto A3, but it just doesn't quite fit on A3. Ugh, bad planning, hey. So instead, it's going in here onto this. So main part of your body. Yes, I wanted to show you how to do this. So if I just give it a quick press. Give it a quick press. There we go. Do you know what? I would do that anyway. For anyone getting the pattern paper, just give it a quick press. We are live again on Facebook. Hello. Look, can I just apologise again? I don't know what is going on tech-wise. It's really hard for me to tell because I don't wear an earpiece because there's no one to talk to. So I don't know. I get like the odd phone call, the odd text message saying, you're live, you're not, you're live, you're not. So apologies. I don't know what's happened this morning. I can only apologise. But we are back again on Facebook. I think the camera froze or something. I don't know. But anyway, we're back. Hello. Welcome. We're just talking through the reversible t-shirt tote pattern, and that is available on the website, and you will get the pattern paper in with it. Now when you start to draw these out, and I did leave myself a pen somewhere, but I've tidied up since, You all watched me tidying up this morning, didn't you? Bear with, let me get another pen. I've bought a few of these because I keep leaving them all over the place. Here we are. Right. So, when you do your pattern pieces, and let's see if it's easier to see on this camera here. Right. So you do your base, and then this is going to end up being a curve. So what you need to do is go along here 7 squares. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and then up 7 squares. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And then you can either get a bowl or you can just, I just use my hand as the sort of, as the swivel point there. But what I would say to you is, you're probably not going to be able to repeat that exact curve over there on the other side. So when you come to cut this out, what I do is get my paper scissors. Which one's my paper ones? Not those ones. These ones. Fold it in half. And I've got my halfway mark lined there. And that's the joy, isn't it, of your squared paper. Is that you know exactly where your halfway line is. And happily it is. It's not like a half anything. So then make sure you've got your paper scissors, paper, paper, paper. Cut that bit. Yep, that's all working. Cut up to there. And then, because you've got it folded in half, you can just go, when you're happy with that curve, you can just cut it and go from there. So you can, if you want, of course you can, use, if you've, actually, if you've got, you know, there are sort of creative grids and stuff, actually, that do curves, but it's okay if you haven't got something like that. Just draw it with your hand. Now, we've got the same situation going on here to here. So if I just open that up so that you can see. So we've got now, yep, we've got a curve, that's all good. We now need to come down and do this curve down the bottom of the bag here. So that is our center point there. That is where it finishes being straight. Again, at that same point that we started to curve there, it's going to echo round there. And you can do it either one of two ways. You can either fold that if you want to and copy that curve down. You can do that, but actually what I would do, again, I know I'm going to that point and I'm going from there, and that is just bring that line down like that. And when I'm happy with it, you know, you can play around with it as much as you like. Once I'm happy with it, then it's a bit like, do you remember when we were kids and you used to do those butterfly pictures? And you used to put paint on one side, then just fold it across. It's a bit like that. And that is how I would tackle. And this is why it's called the T-shirt tote. Ba-ba! Looks like a bra, doesn't it? Don't need to rename it. Well, it's not that sort of a channel, don't you know? Right. I know we're after 9, but it's 9 in the morning. So that is how you would do that bit. Let me just check everyone's joined us again on Facebook so that I can apologise yet again. Yet again? Gosh, yet again? I'm really sorry. And let's see if everybody's found us, shall we? Are you with us? Did you find us again? Here we go. Anybody there? Some of you have found us. Well done, well done. Only just managed to get online, so missed a lot. Do you know what? So have we. Only just managed, Janet. It's been one heck of a morning this morning. Christine said that she was up at four. She was still awake at four. Yeah. You can catch up on YouTube. You're right, Martini. Absolutely can. And I'm sure we can do some sort of crazy cutting and jiggling thing. Morag and Inverness, good morning to you. Ginny, thank you so much for your generosity and kindness. Sarah Payne's quilting book arrived safely. Oh, yes, you were our winner, weren't you? Yes. I'm glad it came to you, actually, because you didn't never confirmed your address. So it was a little bit of a shot in the dark. I was like, I hope this is the right address. But we sent it anyway. Just bought the flamingo fabric, says Anne. Oh, fantastic. I'm glad that you're liking that. They live near a flamingo lake in Cyprus. That's a thing? But of course it's a thing. Yeah. I mean, of course flamingos have to live somewhere. That's amazing. I would love to see that. Oh my goodness me. The curve in between the handles I use for pockets, either inside or out. Oh, good thinking, Elizabeth. Yeah, you see, up there for thinking, down there for dancing. Well done. Hello again, Claire. Yep, we're back again. Sarah says, morning, sweetie. Looks fabulous. Thank you, Sarah. Didn't you escape having to do an early show this morning, you lucky thing? Susan says, I'm here. Hello. Karen says, sorry I'm late, but here now. Hey, look, don't apologise. We've been on off this morning, but we are now in the right place where we should be. Oh, Lorraine's managed to get to her local farm shop. Get you. YouTube picture is really blurry. What? I don't know what's going on today. The gremlins are out in force. Right, should we crack on and make this then? So when you've got all your pattern pieces cut out, and that you'll see that will fit onto that. If you want to make it reversible, then cut two in one colour of that and two in another colour of that. And at the main body of the bag, two in one colour, two in another colour. Let's put those to one side. All of these will be in the instructions. You can always watch it back. In fact, you know what I should probably put on the bottom of the instructions is the date, and then you can watch it on YouTube and put the link. That's an idea. Hey, Josh, if you're watching, write that down. I've peaked. Whee! Okay. Making room. So I had a little rummage through my stash this morning. Oh, look, I nearly got all my pieces cut out. Okay, it does just look like I'm making underwear, doesn't it? You're right. But I'm not. I am not. And this is the other thing, is that you will be sewing these together at some point. So if you are in any way worried, just, you know, cut them all together and get them so that they're sort of the same. There is leeway. Look, we sew all of this with a centimetre seam allowance. Okay, so there is what I like to refer as wiggle room. There's wiggle room. So if it isn't quite spot on, don't panic, don't stress about it. It's okay. You have got wiggle room. And I will tell you, in the 7 years that I've been making this bag, no one has ever stopped to see if all my seams match. They never have. But they do get a lot of lovely comments. It's a great way to showcase all your beautiful fabrics, your favourite fabrics, those ones that we've stroked for a long time and now it's time to do something with. Yeah, you know the ones I mean. Don't pretend that you don't. So there we go. So I've got two green, two grey, and this is just having a little rummage through my stash, seeing what I've got. And then how many versions of this pattern I've got. So I didn't want to, obviously this morning I made it in the beautiful feathers from Philip Jacobs 4K Fassett Collective, for the K Fassett Collective, I did that one. And then my reversible side obviously was the very fun Brandon Mabley 4K Fassett Collective, the zigzags. So I've got that, but I didn't want to use up any more of those fabrics, because otherwise that would be fewer for you guys to have. So there we go. So I had a rummage through my stash and saw what I have. So actually I'm using some of the Fairy Frost fabric for the base, and then just the plain fabric for the top. Now the plain fabric works beautifully for the top because it's not too thick. You've got to turn this through at some point. I've got a contrast colour thread in my sewing machine. Ooh, lime and grey, yes. Yes, yes, yes. And you put, oh, this is the beauty of using a plane as well. Right sides together, but it's a plane, so it's all good. And let's go take this over to the sewing machine, and I am going to, here we go. And it is, yes, I know it is bright pink thread. I'm just going to do, just a line of stitching down, and that will just secure top to bottom. Oh, if I managed to wiggle that. Oh, that's why. Hang on. What have I done? What have I done? Oh, not actually stitch one onto the other. It's going to really help. Just talk amongst yourselves. Like I say, it is one of those days today where, you know, I had a list of things that I had to do. And I got up really early to get everything done. Playing bobbin chicken, aren't I? I've just lost at bobbin chicken. Yeah, so my list included, remember to reload your bobbin. And what I've also discovered is, don't be cheap. If you've got a Juki machine, strangely enough, they work best with Juki bobbins. And I was trying to use bobbins from all sorts of things. And Gary had told me off about it ages ago. Gary from Juki is like, Tash, you're not using proper Juki. Oh, no, come back. Juki bobbins. So I got a little bit told off for that. But he is right. He is right. Juki bobbins actually fit it properly. You might get lucky. And I did with some of my packs of cheap bobbins. But actually, whee! There we go. Let that do its thing for a minute. I won't bother to unpick the bit that hasn't stuck. Oh, by the way, you just do a little curve on the bottom there. Let me, well, I might go crazy and add in some pins. Why not? Why not? There we go, it's finished doing its thing. So I would now actually chain piece all of these. Let's do that. Chain piece all of them. And you get a little, you get into a little flow once things stop going wrong. Then you'll get into a little flow. I like to think I give you a realistic view of sewing. It's warts and all, isn't it? Maybe that's what I should recall this. Warts and all with Natasha Makes. Yeah. I think that's what it is. Is there anything I need to know? Well, you're all there. Well done. Well done on finding us again. On, off, on, off. But here we are. And then again, I'm going to go grey to pick out that frosty bit, but this can be done with any of your fabrics. Obviously, if you've just bought some gorgeous fabrics this morning, then you can use those. You won't get all of it. It's just a bit of a funny shape. You won't get all of it out of a half meter of fabric, what you can do. So the very first time that I made this, I only did a facing, so actually I didn't make it reversible because it had denim on the bottom and it was so thick anyway. And you can do that, you can just do a facing. So use this piece here And just line the top half if you've got something durable, or if you're using upholstery weight fabrics. Because what this does, and being reversible, what it's doing is it's lining it, but doing it in a really beautiful way so that you've got double the bag. But of course you can just do a heavier weight fabric on the base if you want, and just use this pattern, and I'll show you how in a minute. You just hem the bottom and then carry on like we're doing the rest of it. Danielle's Natasha Makes parcels just arrived. Good. Lots of you are actually getting these this morning. Well done. It's one of those things. Oh, I need to apologise. You know when something goes wrong and then just... It's like when you buy something and something goes wrong and then it just keeps going wrong and wrong and wrong. Or when you have a meal and something starts going wrong and then just continues to go wrong. I've had a bit of this. This month's block of the month has been like that. So first of all, one of the fabrics didn't arrive for ages, which meant that it was, it was going to be late. And we apologised for that. And I sent off all of the instructions, printed off however many hundred of the instructions, and sent them off because I don't pack the block of the month here that gets packed for me. It's never arrived. Never arrived. And so finally I had to just admit the fact that it wasn't going to arrive. So I've spent all weekend printing it all off again. They will be posted out today. When you couldn't write it, could you? So yeah, you are still waiting for your block of the month, and I apologise. It's just been a comedy of errors all the way along. So what I'm doing now is I'm printing off block 10 as well. I'm going to send those now so that this doesn't happen again at all. At all. I'm so sorry. You will get them. They are all cut, ready to go. They're just waiting for the instructions now, which will be with you soon. But you will still have time to make them before we do block 10. Hooray. But I know that everyone's getting their deliveries this morning. I had a message from someone the other day saying, Natasha, someone's being mean about you on Facebook because of your delivery times. And do you know what? There are so many things that determine delivery times at the moment. And I can get stuff out within 24, 48 hours of it being ordered. And it can then sit with the post. And we've had this for nearly a week or over a week. So please bear with me. I've admitted when it's me, I put my hands up. Block of the month is me, but everything else we're getting out as fast as we can. And also, sometimes orders that I make that should be here in sort of 2 days are taking 2 weeks. So everything's a little bit up in the air, but we will get them to you eventually. So thank you for all of those who have been. Who've been great if your order's taken a little bit longer to get to you. And also I have cut back. I'm only going to the post office 3 times a week as opposed to every day. And also my post office isn't opening every day anymore either. So that also, and so to the one person that complained, where have you been? where are you living that everything is getting to you on time? I don't know. So there we go. Right, we've done it. We've chain pieced everything. So basically, thank you to everybody else who's been lovely. Look, Sarah says that she's had the same. Sarah Payne Quilter. And I know she breaks her back trying to get stuff out in the post. And she's had, taken up to 2 weeks to get stuff. There's nothing you do, is there? Absolutely nothing. Now, when I press this, I'm going to press it down. So I will start to press. Get all these out of the way for you. Whoops. So press with your main body bit on top and then fold it down, and then like you would if you were quilting, just knock it back. We're going to top stitch. So that seam that we've just done, the reason that my bags last 7+ years is because the stitching is reinforced. Did I say already that this is great for overlocking? Did I? I can't remember. I don't know. So, main body on top. And then knock it back. Again, like you would, but it just means that that seam is pointing down because we're going to top stitch, and what that's going to do is reinforce and make sure, because I am a self-confessed bag over filler. Is this like any bag you've ever made before? I got to it this morning. I haven't made it for a good 6 months. And I did have to do a double take of, have I done this right? Have I? As I was busy writing up all of the instructions for you this morning. Did have one of those days where I thought, where has the time gone? And then I suddenly realised that I have downloaded a week's worth of schooling for Freddie, got that all sorted. And made a pattern, yeah, done that, and written the pattern up and made it, and all those sorts of things. And so I was like, oh, okay. Oh, and got breakfast and fed the dogs and fed the cats and all of that, and unloaded the dishwasher, reloaded the dishwasher, and fed the dogs, fed the cats, because they're so demanding. Although they did look a little bleary-eyed at 4 o'clock this morning. Like, why are you feeding us? So, top stitching. I've done this with about 5/8 centimetre-ish. I'm now going to go across onto 1/4 inch seam just to make it really easy. And again, I'm going to chain stitch down on top of all of these so that everything is going to be secure. Now, in ordinary, I would pick a colour, any colour, that would actually go. But I want you to be able to see my stitches, so it's bright pink. Plus pink is cheery. So we're going with it. Oh, and later, Gemma, I need to pick your brains about what nail polish remover I need to get. I put on a glittery nail polish last week. Can I get it off? Can I? Absolutely no chance. I'm still glittering away all over the place. Which I guess as well is cheery, right? So again, chain piecing all of these. And if you prep all of this, so whilst I said this is perfect for an overlocker, then you could have overlocked your top and your bottom together, but I would still do the finishing bits here, because this just means that it's going to lie beautifully and look fabulous. Last one to go. Oh, look. It's quite a lot of fabric now at the back of that machine. Whee! Off we go again. There we go. And now it looks like a washing line, doesn't it? Oh, it'll all work out beautifully in a minute. It'll be fine. Right. Here we go. So now you want to pair them off. Have we got any questions? Let me just check. Ooh, drop my phone, break it. I've heard from a reliable source, says Carol, that Royal Mail workers are not being paid overtime. So if they don't finish their deliveries by the time they are due to finish work, they take them back to the depot and it's left until the next day. Do you know what? I'm just glad they're working at all, to be honest. Sad they're not being paid overtime, though. I soak cotton wool pads in varnish remover, wrap over each nail and wrap in tin foil for 10 minutes to get glitter polish off. Oh, Karen. It's 10 minutes that I can't be doing other stuff. Oh, yeah, no, you're all saying, yeah. Yeah. Sunny Camden, says another Karen. Lots of Karens this morning. Good morning. I'll do that, though, because it's still glittery in places. Right. Right sides together. We're going to ignore... we're going to ignore these bits. We're going to ignore the straps for now. And all we're going to do is... And this is where you can whip out your overlocker. All we're going to do is sew from this straight line all the way around. Now we'll do that on one, and then on the other one we'll leave a turning through gap. I've started leaving my turning through gaps at the side, because then when you open your bag, you don't see, because I top stitch my turning through gaps because I'm lazy slash don't have enough time. So actually you don't see them if it's on the side. So if I remember, that is what I'll do. Can you use fat quarters for the bag? Michelle, yes you can. So, yeah, but each bit would be a fat quarter, if you see what I mean. So the bottom bit, these came out of fat quarters. So you could, You could use a different fat quarter for each bit. That would look amazing. That would look really amazing, like a jigsaw, wouldn't it? So yeah, that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to go back to my wider stitch. And again, if your bits and pieces don't match up, there is leeway. But what I would just try to do is try to match that seam on the side. That's all I would say. Let's just do that a bit and then go around a bit. And off we go. So again, there is enough leeway in that seam allowance that you do not have to worry. You can pin it, of course you can pin it. This is why I love my machine. Look at that round the corner. No hands. Look, see, no hands. All I'm doing is making sure that it just gets fed evenly through. And we can whiz around. You will take your time, obviously. But with the DX7, I can program so that every time I lift my foot off the foot pedal, it lifts that little foot there, which is fabulous. And it does make corners so much easier. Right, just matching up these lines here. That's the beauty of the fabric, isn't it? You can manipulate it a bit. I've made my mum these. We've all got them in our family. If you've known me for any length of time, you've normally got one, to be fair. There we go. But you are just sewing around there. So the two straight lines, we're ignoring all of this curvy malarkey, ignore that for now. So that's one of them. And then we're going to do the same, exactly the same, right sides together. But I'm going to remember to leave a turning through gap, right? Note to self. Do you remember this morning when I was tidying up? And I had to swiftly remove the unpicker from general view. Yeah, so I might not have remembered that this morning. I might have had to find me a bit and unpick it. But if I put a little pin in here, then I will remember. Oh, Elizabeth says she likes the tone effect I've got going on here. Stylish. Thank you very much. But this is the thing. We all have stash. And if you don't have stash, you've got no excuse, because I did do incredible value fabrics this morning for you. So you can always build into your stash. And but some bags don't go the distance. This will last you. Right. Let's go again. Let's go again. Back to the machine. Hurrah. Now, let's talk dressmaking, shall we, for a minute. And I need to apologise a bit for Lorraine, because she was asking when dressmaking is going to be back on our Natasha Makes screens. And I was a bit like, well, not really sure. I'm not sure, not because I don't have things in the pipeline, but just because... obviously, guests are a little bit difficult at the moment. Not difficult. Oh, hi, Arthur. Come on in. Let yourself in. Can you hear the jingly jangly of the door? That's my spaniel letting himself in. You just come in and sit down. Make yourself at home, love. Oh, you have. Excellent. You let all the cold air in, Arthur. It was nice and warm in here. So dressmaking. Sorry, because obviously we're all getting our dressmaking what have you on with the sewing bee. So guests, I was really lucky with Sarah and Angie. They had both been quarantined for 2 weeks before they came, so I knew that they were safe to have in the house, because obviously, you know, the kids run around as well, so I've got to be safe for them as well. None of my dressmaking guests have quarantined enough that they can come for my liking. So I can make a pair of pajamas and a few other things, but honestly, I'm not an expert. One of my suppliers says, you can dress make, Natasha, you just choose not to. He's kind of right. When I have to, I can. I remember making over 50 jackets for a school play once and going, never again, never again. And that was the really crazy thing. That was to my own pattern as well. So, you know, sometimes, yeah, I undersell myself quite a lot. Right, okay, so we've left a turning through hole there. So yeah, in answer to the dressmaking question, it's not forgotten about. I just can't tell you when. There are obviously things in the pipeline. I just can't tell you when. That's all. One inside the other, right sides together. So we've sewn both of those wrong sides together, right sides together rather. Turn one through. And if you want to clip the corners to get a nice gentle curve, then do. Stuff this one, the right sides together one, through into this one, so that then they are indeed right sides together, but just one inside the other. And then it looks a bit of a mess. But do not despair. That's where my nice pins have gone. Right, found them. Good. Start at the seam. So those seams, the top of those seams, start there. And pin. And we're going to go around and pin, well, you can if you want. I basically pin every now and then. I pin one there, and then at the top, I will pin again. But again, you've got quite a generous seam allowance, so I'm really not gonna stress. I will pin again at the top. I'm not going to stress if it's a bit wibbly wobbly here and there. It's a very forgiving bag, this one. I like, you know me, if it needs to be super duper accurate, then yeah, I need to think about that. Right, and then pin again up there. And this is easily a bag that you'll get done in a morning. They make great gifts. They make nice, sturdy bags. The one I got out of the cupboard actually to look, because obviously, like I say, I've got quite a lot of these are at the post office, because I do, in the interests of trying to not hang about anywhere at the moment, I do this thing called drop and go at the post office. So basically I just drop my bags at the counter and leg it, so I don't have to hang about or touch anything, which means that next time I go, they hand me back loads of bags. So some of them were there. But actually, my other bag, it's got all sorts in, because it's the one that I take over to Hachanda with me. Yeah, it's got all sorts of goodies in it. So now I'm going to start at the seam, so you can fit a lot in. And I'm going to sew all the way up, woo, and round, and keep going, wee, all the way around until we get to there. Anna's just clapping. She's replying to Martine. I thought it was a bit early for a round of applause. I'm not quite sure what you're doing. Okay, let's have a go, shall we? Let's have a go. Sounds so professional. Let's give it a go. Like I've never made one of these before. Let's just give it a go. Fingers crossed, it'll work. let's move that out of the way. Let's get you a little close up. So you said, how much fabric do you need for each bag? Well, it depends. I would say, because it doesn't quite come out of a half meter. So that's why I ended up making it contrasting, so that I had an excuse to crack into others. But because it doesn't quite come out of a full half metre, all of it, for each colourway, you do get loads left over. So I would say basically a fat quarter for each section. But if you've bought a couple of the kits today, if you bought a couple of the $9.99 two half meters, two of those would make one of these bags with so much fabric left over. Oh, back up. I've overshot that mark. Yeah. It's just because it's a bit of a funny shape. I went through, when I used to make these all the time, I went through a stage of having lots of weird and wonderfully curved shapes left in my in my scrap bag. And actually, anyone who gets my most recent scrap bags will also get some weird and wonderfully shaped scraps. Now, I loaded another 8 scrap bags to the website this morning. So anybody that's after some good scraps, my scrap bags just keep getting better and better, because normally I would use every inch of scraps, but now if it's at the end of a bolt, it goes in the scrap bag. If it's left over from, whoops, a bit wobbly there, pay attention, Natasha. Like I say, it's very forgiving. If it's left over from show prep, goes in the bag. So yeah, if you wanted some scraps, I've got, like I say, I've loaded a few of those up today as well. So actually, I have been quite busy this morning when I think about it. I did wonder where the time had gone. And around we go. So I've taken off this. So this is how, you know, the way that you would obviously have your sleeve, if you were doing sleeves, dressmaking, see, secretly dressmaking. But it just helps get everything around. So we've done half, and then we just keep on, you're in the flow, and you just keep on going around. And obviously you will do this and take lots of time and care over it. Not go hell for leather at it like I am. And again, I cut one handle slightly longer than the other. It's not the end of the world. It really isn't. Now, I've suggested sort of a centimetre seam allowance. You honestly don't have to. I've realised now I'm not even probably using that much of a seam allowance. But what I would say is, whatever you use, just be consistent with it. That's all. Just be consistent. Yeah, so one of these really is much narrower than the other, but don't worry about it. If I'd have pinned this to bits, then we'd probably be in better shape, but you know, that's not the most scintillating thing to watch, is it? Me pinning stuff. And you'll see in a minute, it doesn't matter. If you've never made a bag like this before, give it a go. It is actually really good fun. And you're probably thinking, how on earth is this actually going to happen? Wait and see. Okay, so we've gone all the way around there. And now, two things are going to happen. First of all, we're not going to worry about the state of our seams, because we're going to trim them back. So get your pinking shears. We don't need the bulk in the handle, but what we do want is it to be able, especially around this curve, to be able to curve. So get those pinking shears out, trim back. And then nobody will know if you didn't quite cut everything out so that it was perfect. Nobody knows. Nobody cares. Here we go. Trim it back. I think I got far more relaxed with my sewing, having so spent so many years on sewing quarter, watching professionals go, oh, well, that didn't quite meet. Let's not worry about that. And I'm thinking, there I am, having an absolute meltdown if things don't quite match. And the professionals are all like, oh, well, you know, happens, isn't it? Just happens. So I thought, well, yeah, let's just get things made, shall we? And, you know, obviously if I was looking to sell this or something, then I possibly wouldn't if it was really wonky. But if it's a gift to someone, and I don't know about you, but I have found myself doing that an awful lot more, sending little gifts up to people. So be it, you know, the pouches that we had the other day, the zip pouches. I stuffed some of that full of chocolate for my mum. My mum, bless her, she my mum's normally asleep on the sofa by 9:30. She's a morning person. She's like me. She doesn't do evenings. So when she then set her alarm to get up at 1 o'clock in the morning to try and get an online shopping space, I mean, that's what it's come to for, bless her. And I feel awful because I don't live near, so I can't even drop anything off. And so she did all her shopping online. She managed to get a spot at 1 o'clock in the morning. But in her dozy state, forgot to order any chocolate. She was distraught. She's like, I'm going to have to ration myself. This is dreadful. And from one chocoholic to another, I thought, oh, Mum, I can't let this happen. So on one of my little post office runs, I managed to get her some supplies, stuff it in one of the pouches I made on the show and post it down to her. You know, needs must and all that. And so she's received that now. I couldn't tell her last week that I'd done it because it had to be a surprise. Took forever. And there's only so many times that you can keep saying to someone, she post arrived yet? And a card that Emily had made her arrived 2 days, posted on the same day, arrived 2 days before the other one. That's what I mean about the post at the moment. And it's not their fault. They are working their socks off. I'm not complaining. It's merely an observation. But yeah, I was like, oh, you got the card from Emily. Anything else? She got a little bag, a little pouch full of chocolate. And, you know, I just find myself doing little things like that for people at the minute. And my niece and nephew, they will be getting one of the book cushions. Oh, I think I might have some fabric to do a few more of the glow-in-the-dark book cushions. So let me know if you want any more of those. Right, so at the moment, it's inside out, it's back to front, and the handles aren't sewn up together. You're thinking, why am I bothering to watch this woman? She doesn't even know what she's doing. Let's have a look at this. You need to turn it all through the right way. And it is a bit weird. I'll give you that. It is a bit weird. But bear with me, because it will work. And this is where we're grateful that we remembered to leave a turning through gap. And it will look like that. And it will look like you don't have any handles. You'll be like, what on earth? What is going on? If you have a turning through tool, get it now, because you're going to need it. If you don't, then you're just going to have to spend a little bit of time wiggling stuff. But basically, that is one of your handles. If you have a turning through tool, turn it through now. And then, but also a kebab stick will also do the job. Next one, so you've got four of these to find. I've lost my turning through gap. You need to find your turning through gap. And then, like I say, if you've got, I can't find a supplier for the turning through tool. I need to broaden my search. There we go. Keep losing it. There it is. You just want to ease out, by the way, your corners. And I do mean ease. I don't mean like really ram the stick in there and go through the fabric. We've all done that before. And you start to get starting to look. Dee 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 dee. Ah, can't find it because it's this side, isn't it? So through it goes. And you, look, for years before I had a turning tool, all I did was just battle this for a little bit. And it's all good. And then the last one is it this one? Yeah. There we go. Let's go back in there. So I'm going in with the flat end of the turning tool first to push through, and then going in with the pointed end just to poke out those edges. And it's still looking weird. You're like, what is going on? I promise you it's right. I promise. Now, you see, before you do that, you might want to sew up your turning through hole. And I just top stitch. Obviously, if I was making this just, you know, not on TV and contrasting fabric, then I would actually find a fabric that wasn't bright pink and wasn't gonna scream, ha ha, look what you've done. But, you know, in the interests of time, blah, 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 I will just top stitch that. You can slip stitch it, you don't have to top stitch it. To be honest, I've come to use some bags that I've put in the back of the cupboard and got them out and gone, oh, didn't even bother to sew that up at all then, eh? Didn't even bother. But yes, I would. And because it's going to be reversible, obviously I would probably slip stitch that or do it in a thread that isn't going to scream at me. Let's stuff that colour inside, shall we? So that then goes into, very technical way to do this, isn't there? Floofing it around all over the place. Can you imagine what I'm like when I'm trying to put a duvet into a duvet cover? Oh, that doesn't make good watching. I used to have a boyfriend that had a 6'8" wingspan. I tell you what, that was fabulous. Best thing about him was that I didn't have to ever put the sheets on the bed, because his arms just he would just do it. It was great. Yeah, there are certain things in life I'm just not good at, and that's one of them. Okay, so now it's starting to look more how we want it to, right? Is it? Yes, it is. Look, there we go. So now, get rid of the threads. Bump, bump, bump. We're going to press all around here. And you see, look, when you open it up, you've got your contrast. I love these. I really love these. Okay, let me get my pressing mat. Here we go. And then just gently. Through there and through there, and this is where I'm very grateful that I trimmed back with my pinking shears. It's not a difficult word, but it evades me. There we go. Oh, hello. My phone's WhatsApp is going crazy. It's one of the school mums groups. What's going on? I have to roll my quilt cover on. It's like a magic trick. Yeah, no, just no good at it. There are just some things in life I was not made to do. And, you know, I take my hat off completely to chambermaids who change like 100 beds a day. That would be my idea of hell. Absolute hell. I just don't know how they do it. No one really wants to sleep in a bed I've made. That, you know, my mum always makes them look like hotels, you know, really, really lovely. You know, I go and stay at her house and it's like, ah, oh, this is amazing. Nothing like, I managed to crumple it. She manages to make it all smooth yet plumped. I used to call pinking shears up scissors. Oh, okay, yeah, I get that. Cool. Right, so now what we're going to do is top stitch. And we're going to start again. I start and finish at seam just because then I remember where I've been. And again, you would use a thread that goes. I'm going to use a contrasting one, i.e. the pink. And then, yeah, just all the way around. And it just, again, it's reinforcing and it's making sure that everything sits nicely and all those sorts of things. And I will move my stitch across to a quarter of an inch and use my foot as a guide. I will do a locking stitch first of all, and then around we go. And I will try and do this as quickly as I can, because it is one of those things, you think you've got to the end of it and then you realize actually You've only done one side. So you would take lots of time and effort. Oh no, 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 what's happened? Oh, my thread snapped. Talk amongst ourselves again. Some days it's just like that. My machine needs a little service. It's been working hard, but it does need a little service now. Oh, that way helps. And a bit of a clean, actually, looking at the state of it. Right, let's go again. Do, 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 do. But happily, oh, that's the other thing. I can get it serviced. A, because this is why, this is another reason that when I chose which sewing machines I wanted. Obviously, this sewing machine comes with a 5-year warranty. And even during lockdown, I can get it serviced. They will collect it, pick it up, do what they need to, and send it back again. Normally, I would take it to my high street dealer. So if you do buy a sewing machine from Natasha Makes, then it has a Juki guarantee. This one and the NX7 has a Juki warranty. Or this one has 5 years on it. And part of the money that you pay when you buy your machine from me goes to your local high street shop. So we're even supporting high street shops, even when they're shut in these times. And they will take over your warranty and your servicing of your machine if you can't get to them, Juki themselves. So at this current moment in time, rather than going to my high street, Juki will come and pick it up, take it away, service it, drop it back, we're all good. And that is all in with the price that you pay for the machine, and I think that's cracking. I remember, I think I've told you this story before, at an awards ceremony, sitting next to a lady that sold sewing machines for a living and saying how shopping channels were really damaging for her. There was one particular machine that had been sold a lot of, and she's like, I just can't compete. And it stuck with me. She was ever such a nice lady, and I thought, when I sell machines, I don't want the high street stores to miss out. So they don't, because they actually... Okay, so would have helped if I'd pressed this well. Yeah, so the high street stores, they get a cut for servicing. So that sat well with me. I was like, okay, that's all right. We can all support each other here. There's no need to be greedy, is there? There we go. So yeah, take care when you are pressing that you don't fold over your fabrics like I did there, because I'm in a rush. And this is what I mean. So normally I'd be thinking, oh, look, I'm done. No, 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 you are only halfway. So we go again. Hooray! But I have to say, little features on this machine, like that needle down, foot up, just make going around corners and being able to demonstrate it to you far easier, because I'm not always having to put my hand at the back of the machine and turn everything round and da 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 da. I know it's going to sew straight, and I know it's going to do what I need it to do, which is fab. Ooh, the concentration. Round we go. We're nearly there, you know. We are nearly there. Now, like I say, I've done ones where I've only had a little bit of designer super special fabric, and I've done these so that I've just used inexpensive lining fabrics, contrast lining fabrics on the inside. I've done them so that each panel has been different. Oh, that might be quite nice. If you've got sort of different fat quarters, you could do a different fat quarter for each bit of it. That would be amazing. That would look really good. I've done exactly the same on this side. I haven't actually pressed it on the seam. Take some care and attention when you're pressing your seams. Here we go, round we go. Do you know what? I know I said that I would normally use a thread that went, but actually, I'm quite enjoying the pink. It's a bit jolly. So just all the way around like that. Trim off any edges. Well, I guess green and pink and lime and pink and grey and pink, it all works, isn't it? So that's all now sitting all very nicely. And then get yourself a little ruler. I use my Perfect Five. Where's it been all my life? I don't know how I actually used to manage. Oh, Elizabeth likes the look of the Dookie. It's brilliant. Absolutely love it. No, don't put pins in your mouth. Right, I am going to, with my little ruler, just measure down an inch and a half. So if you're in centimetres, about 4 centimetres, and pop in a pin. There, same on this side. I will measure down. Whoop. An inch, well, I'm folding over. I'm lining up my ruler there. There's my inch and a half mark there, and I'm folding that over onto that inch and a half line, and then just popping in a pin. And then all I'm going to do is sew a little square over the top. I'll follow that stitch line, sew a little square, and then a cross. And then that's it done. That is the whole bag done. So should we go and do that? Shall we? That's the camera angle I want. Across we go. Yeah, Elizabeth, going back to the Dookie, it's peace of mind. That's what it is. A friend of mine bought her machine off Amazon. It didn't come with a very long warranty, and it's rusted inside, which is awful. And when she rang up, the guarantee was out. And they're like, yeah, that's what this certain make of machine does. So that was it. You know, she'd only had it sort of 12 months and the machine had rusted. And they weren't surprised, which is even worse. So when you hear horror stories like that, it makes me incredibly grateful that I have the make of machine that I have. Now, when I get to this corner, so I've gone round 4, I'm then just going to spin around and I'm going to come across corner to corner. You can mark this out if you want to be super accurate. And then again, I'll go from this corner here. Across to that one. Da. And there you go, just a little cross like that. And the same. Oh, let's start here so I don't have to start by taking out a pin. That could be disastrous. But like I say, in all the years that I've made these bags, I have never, ever, ever, obviously really wanting to jinx this now, I've never had the handle's come undone. This is strong enough. I've never had any of it come undone, actually, because it's all reinforced. Now, we've reinforced it with top stitching and this, that, and the other. If you're overlocking it, then you're laughing because, you know, you've got great construction there. Anyway, so again, when I've gone round my four sides, and then across the other side, there. Whee! And we're done. There it is. Ta-da! And I will then just neaten it up, snip those threads, but that is that done. And it is reversible. And it has been fun to make. And apologies to those of you, again, that missed the start of the show this morning. You can find it on YouTube. You can, oh, it helps if I actually show you what I'm doing, doesn't it? You can find it on YouTube. You can find it on the website, www.natashamakes.com. All of our videos will be there as well. So if you decide to get the pattern and then make it in a week's time, a month's time, a year's time, they will all be on our website for you. They will also always be on Natasha Makes YouTube channel as well. You can watch them there. It's all there. And it will be on Facebook as well. So you can always find it. And that is the bag made. And that's what you get the glimpse of. And then if you want just a change of pace, that is your other side. Cool, hey. And so it just, you've got two bags in one. With whatever fabrics you choose to do them in. I think they're a bit of fun, and I always like making them. So I just thought I'd bring them to wear for you as something just a little bit different. So make the most of our half metre heaven, where you get 2 half metres for £9.99 on the website. That is going to be a feature, like I say, and I will just repeat myself here because I know a lot of you struggled to get on because of the trouble we had with Facebook this morning. That is going to be a feature that we're going to launch every Thursday, so watch out for it. And if you have signed up to the website, then we will send you links to remind you and to preview, and you will get first dibs. So when the email comes out, you know, often that's when things will go live. So you'll get, if you've signed up to the website, which is natashamakes.com, then you will get first dibs in that, and a first heads up for any deals and offers and what have you for that. So that's always worth signing up for. And thank you again for everybody that has ordered, and apologies again for the block of the month. You will get it. I'm posting off my second lot of instructions because the first lot never arrived. So good. What else? Tomorrow, we will be making storage. Gorgeous storage with a bit of Moda and a bit of Tilda, all sorts. Blues are the way forward, with a little bit of something for the kids as well. So if you're doing storage for the kids' bedroom, because actually you realise just how grubby and messy they are now that, you know, they're home all the time, then you can also get them to help you with that as well. But I think these are fab, and I think they will cheer up any room. Oh yeah, pop them there. So we'll be making those tomorrow. Thank you for joining us. Have a good peruse on the website. See what you can find in there. And yeah, I think that is us done for this morning. Thank you very, very much for your time. I'm off to do some yoga, hence being dressed like this. When I say I'm off to, I'm going to walk to the room next to this one and do some. I'm not going anywhere. Not going anywhere. So stay home, stay safe. I will see you here 10 o'clock tomorrow morning, and hopefully all of our IT-based gremlins will be ironed out, an absolute treat. So take care and stay safe. Lots of love. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.